Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I thought that I would show you how to muck out a horse, well, how I do it.
Mucking out a horse, but obviously I mean mucking out a stall, so yeah.
I know there is different ways to mucking out a horse, and the horse that I love now is quite messy. So I've recently learned a very good method about mucking out a horse.
I still keep saying mucking out a horse, but I still mean a stall.
Well, mucking out a horse type, like how this barn stall looks. So I thought that I would just show you what you might need to muck out and stuff like that. If you have never mucked out a horse before, this is sort of a way to do it. And of course, riding schools and others have different ways to do it, and you should get to know the ways that they are doing it, because of waste of shavings and stuff like that. And if you don't have shavings, you might have something else underneath the horse. But right now I'm dealing with shavings, and that's totally okay, so I thought that I would show you how to muck out a messy horse. So first of all, for mucking out, you might need some equipment, and the equipment that I'm going to show you that I use when I muck out is a wheelbarrow and a pitchfork. I know some people just use their hands and some people use buckets, but I do use a wheelbarrow and a pitchfork.
This is the wheelbarrow that I use and the pitchfork that I use, and here is the stall that is going to be mucked out. It's quite messy because the horse I loan is a quite messy gentleman. So this is what I'm going to get clean, and you will see another result than this. And yeah, as you can see, I have some work to do. First thing I start off with is removing the hay that got on the ground, and because it's full of shavings and he has peed in it and it's poop in it, so obviously it will be removed from the stall. So that is what I'm trying to do here, and trying to save most of the shavings that aren't being infected by poop and pee. So that is currently what I'm doing here. Then I am trying to save as much shavings that I can before I really start mucking out, because sometimes shavings is worth saving, so this is what I am trying to do here. Then the real thing is on. I'm starting to remove every pee and poop stain here. I know where the horse pees and I know where the horse poops, so for me this is quite easy to remove, and it looks like I'm removing a lot of clean shavings. I might be removing a bit of clean shavings, but it's like totally like with small traces of poop in them, so that's why it goes into the wheelbarrow, because I want a clean stall when it's a clean stall. So apparently I am doing my best here to get out everything that is infected by pee and poop. The reason why we are mucking out a stall on a daily basis is actually because of the horse's hoof and their hoof care, and actually the horse's health, because if the horse is standing in their droppings and their pee for a long time, their hoof will actually be destroyed by the ammoniac. So if you ever see a horse stall that is made for days, I think you should either report the owners, or you should go and muck it out yourself. Or if it's in a riding school and they haven't mucked out for days, it's actually a reason to report, because it should be done every single day. If the horse is kept in a stall, then it should be mucked out every single day. So there's the pile with the clean shavings that I saved, and then I'm going to go underneath the rubber mats, because there is a lot of shavings underneath there as well that is filled with pee, so I have to take it out. So yeah, that is what I'm going to do right now. And because I don't have the strength to take up the rubber mats, I'm going underneath them with my shoes, and I actually get a lot out. So I just scrape the floor and the shavings with my shoes to get it out and to put it in the wheelbarrow, and I do that with all the sides of the mat, on both the mats. And these mats cover most of his stall, so wherever it isn't covered with rubber mats, he has shavings. So it makes it quite easy to actually clean out his stall. When that's done, I've used a broom to just swipe everything in the middle, and then I take everything away. So what's left in the middle right now is the clean shavings, and then I'm going to put the pile of shavings in between the rubber mats again, because that's how it's done. And then I get a last good shake and clean in the clean shavings. So here I'm shaking it off, taking the pile with the mostly clean shavings to put in the middle, and while I do that, I just give it one more shake so I'm sure that I have everything that doesn't need to be in there, I have in the wheelbarrow. So when I leave the stall, it's perfectly good for a horse to come in there, and if he needs to roll, he doesn't need to roll in poop and pee, and he has a fresh, clean bed for the night. So enjoy me shaking it off. Finished results with the rubber mat, and because of the mats he doesn't need that much shavings, but here is a good amount of shavings and the dirty shavings.
And if you like this video, please like, comment and subscribe, right?